Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Well, today a question, this was a call. I was driving in the car. I got a call from Patricia. Patricia works at a school in Arizona. I think it was Patricia. School in Arizona, and I recognized the question immediately. She says she has a start date and an end date. She needs to figure out how many of those students were enrolled on October 1st. That's a very common problem. Our school here in Ohio, I know that we get a payment for every student who's enrolled on October 1st. So, provided they show up by October, that's great. The kids who move into the district on October 2nd, you know, we're supposed to educate them for free. So, go figure, their last school district got the money. Kind of a strange way to do it, but I recognize the question right away. So, here's what we talked about on the phone with Patricia. Patricia, first thing I want to do is I want to do an if statement, of course, right? If. But there's two conditions we have to check for. So, I'm going to use an and function. And I'm going to check that earlier date, the start date in A2, see if that's less than or equal to my date up here in the blank cell, the formerly blank cell. And we press F4 to lock that down, because as we copy that down, I want the A2 to be relative, but the E1 has to be frozen. And then the next condition, we'll see if the date in B2 is greater than or equal to that date. We'll press F4, close the and now, well, what to do if it's true? I'm going to put a 1. If it's true, I put a 1, and otherwise I put a 0. That way we can just count how many we get, sum this up, basically. So I have all my students there. It looks like the sum is 5 down here in the lower left-hand corner. So a great way to go. Now, what we did, we said, you know, let's do a little test. Let's just change some dates here on one of these test records and make sure that it's working. So there we go, that's good. If the person had left on 9/17/2008, then they're not in. So there you have it, great way to go. A very common problem for everyone in a school district. We have to measure that. Kind of a tougher formula than you think it might be, but certainly a good way to go. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast. Mr. Excel.